Hey guys, what's going on? My name is Nice Guy Gamer, and this is WWE 2K20 My Career Mode Episode 16. As we're going to have Trey versus The Undertaker. Last man standing, last ride match, or Hell in a Cell? So this is going to be a last ride match against The Undertaker. Well, I never wrestled in a last ride match, but this is a first time that Robert Jackson is going to face off against The Undertaker in it. So we're taking it to The Undertaker right now. So I hit him with the signature, and now it says, perform your finisher on The Undertaker near the hearse to the right of the entrance ramp. Oh no. We'll be right back, guys. This has gotta be it. German suplex into the ripcord lariat. Thank you. He's got him up. And the Undertaker's in. Uh-oh, now we got Becky Lynch, Drew McIntyre, Pete Dunne, Sheamus, and Finn Balor.
World and summoned the Undertaker to the Earth Realm so I could defeat him and cement my Hall of Fame legacy. We're fine, thanks.
I told you they wouldn't believe it.
You know what? None of that crazy stuff ever happened. I mean, sure, I beat the Undertaker. You all witnessed that. But could you imagine all that other wacky stuff? Portals and Marsh Ladies and Papa Shango?
Yeah, gotcha. Joke's on you.
Anyway, let's get back to things that actually happened.
Like when I was the longest reigning women's champion of the modern era, holding the SmackDown Live Women's Championship for over 2.5 years.
I'm gonna skip the continued story.
The SmackDown Live Women's Champion is ready to address the WWE Universe.
Since I defeated Mickie James over 2.5 years ago, I've had the privilege of defending this championship against the very best female competitors in WWE. But when you're the longest reigning women's champion in the modern era, it's only natural you start to look for new ways to challenge yourself. And considering it's a little Wild West around here right now with no GM, I figured this was my chance to do that. So I thought about doing an open challenge, but that's a little played out. I could force myself to win with a 4 or 5 count, maybe. Or I could do something really unprecedented and defend my title against male superstars. So what do you think?
Uh-oh. That's Becky Lynch's music. Can't... This reminds me of the WWE 12 villain story. And Sheamus was the members of a
so
different.
You give yourself new challenges like 5 counts of facing men. Well, I have a better idea. How about you forget all that and face the man?
It's funny you still throw around that title. After all these years, I mean, I'm the one who's held an actual title longer than anyone since the 1970s. So, I'm pretty sure that makes me the man.
I am the man because I'm the leader of the most powerful force this sport has ever seen. And that's when there's someone in charge. So just think of what we're capable of when no one's steering the ship. So unless you want to find out what happens when we have free reign, I suggest you give me my title match tonight.
If you didn't hear me the first time, I'm looking for new challenges, not rematches against played out losers I've already beat. And you and your crew trying to intimidate me isn't going to change that. Besides, everyone knows you're just all bitch and no butt.
Well, if you're not gonna give me a title match, then I'll just have to beat one out of you. Boys, little help. I'm gonna show Red here my bite.
Now, Becky Lynch has got a chair.
So far, Red has
Here comes Robert.
Disadvantage. We saw what happened out there, and we want to help. Great. Where were you 15 minutes ago?
We all had severe simultaneous leg cramp syndrome, or SSLCS.
What?
Proven medical condition that can occur when superstars team as long as we have, and their body's ailments become synchronized.
I don't think they're buying it.
The truth is that we didn't want to get involved in your business. We know sometimes certain people can be a bit stubborn about wanting to do things on their own.
He's talking about you.
Nah, it could be anyone.
It's fine. I know I'm stubborn, but I'm not stupid. I can recognize when we need help, so we'll take it. Thank you.
So do we do like a secret New Day handshake now or something?
How about you two rest up, and next week we'll see what we can do about Becky and her crew.
Sounds good. Not long after my issues with Becky Lynch heated up, SmackDown Live filled its open GM position. We were excited to see who it was. Well, until we saw who it was.
No. No, come on.
I'm so excited to be the new general manager of SmackDown Live.
Did you just come out here, interrupt us, and say SmackDown Live?
She definitely said that, and I have 20/20 hearing.
You're off to a good start, Jim. Please, continue.
Knowing that I was up for this gig, I watched the show last week for the first time, and I have to say, I didn't like what I saw from you, Red. Instead of accepting Becky Lynch's challenge, you resorted to cheap insults, which led to Becky having no choice but to defend herself. So, Red, you said last week you wanted new challenges? Well, I have one for you. You're going to defend your women's championship in the first ever best out of five team match. It will be a one-night series of singles matches between Red, Trey, and your buddies The New Day, taking on Becky Lynch and her Savages. If Red's team wins the series, she retains her title. If Becky's team wins, she is the new SmackDown Live Women's Champion.
It's SmackDown Live.
The name of your show is SmackDown Live. Say it with me. SmackDown.
Town makes more sense, but whatever.
Losing track of the fact she just put us in a best out of five series for Red's title, which seems super unfair. I mean, who would do such a thing? Hey, I know we formed an alliance, but that's kind of our thing, okay? With all due respect, you're really stacking the deck against Red, so I have an idea that would help even things up a bit. You give our team home field advantage.
That's right. If Red's putting her title on the line with these circumstances, then the series should take place on our turf.
What kind of turf are we talking? Synthetic or natural? Because I prefer a natural tall festival.
I meant more of a New Day home arena vibe, but we could look into the festival.
That was a test. You passed. Good job.
There's really not a bad choice, unlike the choice of Brooklyn as GM.
Ooh, she just laid the smack town on her.
Please stop. Please.
So I'm going to team with...
Great decision. Ooh, I can smell the sweet aroma of tall vestibule head all the way.
Home field advantage is on the line later tonight on SmackDown.
So it's going to be Casey and Robert versus Becky Lynch and Finn Balor. Be right back, guys. So Becky Lynch made the tag to Finn Balor. We'll be right back. Uh-oh, Becky Lynch with the reversal. This could be it for Becky Lynch. Go to sleep. There's a cover. And that's it. This is one of the weirdest arenas I've ever seen.
Wait, what did you say?
Yeah, you know how they used Mr. McMahon's home as the old In Your House entrance? My uncle knew a security guard, who knew a janitor, who knew a concession stand worker, who worked at one of the arenas, and he told him that it was Vince's actual house.
We need to have a talk, lady. Guys. We could continue to dilly-dally, or we could get things started with the first match.
I'm normally a strong proponent of dillying and dallying, but I think we should get to smash.
In that case, let's kick things off with our first contest of the evening. You're Kofi.
So Kofi Kingston versus Pete Dunne. Well, guys, I'm going to end this video right here, but I will start episode 17. And we'll see you guys there.